Hi, welcome back in the Windows 8.1 UX Design Jumpstart. My name is Martin Tierien. I'm User Experience Evangelist with Microsoft in the Netherlands. And with me is Chris.
Hi, I'm Chris Mayo. I'm a User Experience Evangelist with Microsoft as well.
So in this session, we'll talk about start tiles, notifications, and the lock screen, and what that means for your app. So we've talked a lot about your app being great at things and have core scenarios, etc. But also outside of your app, you want your app to be live and really feel alive and really interact with the user. And there are a few ways you can do that to draw people back into your app and make them see that there's maybe new information or things like that in your app, so they want to come back over and over again to your app and use that. Now, one way to do that is with the tiles, and this is a screenshot, but maybe it's better to just show my start screen. And you see there's all kind of things happening here. For instance, there's the weather there of different country or different places. I see what's new in store, or I see the news, or what's new in sports. So all kind of things are updated on the screen in these tiles, and the tiles are alive. So it makes me go back to these apps and really dig into that again. So that's a possibility that you can do in your app as well. And one of the things that you can do is using tiles for that. So let's go back to the start screen again. And for instance, when you see here the sports app, you see the tile in the middle with 10 reasons, etc. There's an image there. So if I'm a fan of this or I'm interested in that news, in the sport news, I might be interested in it. And when I open up the app, you see that the issue is there as well. So it's the same content that's there. So that's already a key part, that when there are things in the live tile, when I open up the app, I expect the content to be there, because that was what triggered my intention to open up the app again. So another example, when I go to the start screen and you see my mails, for instance, now on the top left, you see there's this one. I tried to move it around. This one. You see there's a badge there. It says I have 5 new emails in this account. When I resize it, make it very large, for instance, it shows 3x3. The latest mails there, and of course these are not very useful mails, but just to show that you see some of the content there. The title is there and the first line is there, so it gives me an indication what the mail is about, and it really depends on how big it is. So when it goes to wide, it just shows one mail at a time and shows who the sender is. Now I did send mail to myself, which is a bit pitiful, but okay, it's just for the demo, right? And when I resize it again, go to medium, you saw the tile that we saw before, it just has a badge, it just says there are five new ones. And when I make it really small, you see that still the badge is there. So it gives me an indication there is something new here, and it gives me a reason to open up the app again. So that's a thing you can do. And of course, what you can do as well is that if you don't want these animations with the live tiles, you can also switch it off. So for instance, if I pick up this app here, I can just turn live tile off. And when I do that, I just see the logo of the app and not all the interaction anymore. So again, me as a user, I'm in control. My default live tiles are on, but I can switch it off for all the tiles that I want to. Another thing is what you can do with tiles. Let me go back to the sports app again. Now, I might not be a football fan, but maybe I'm an NBA fan. So I go to the NBA part in the sports app. I have the possibility to pin it to my start screen. So let me pin this. I can give it a name. So I can give it any name, but this sounds appropriate. No, it gave it baseball.
Yeah.
That's a very good one, actually. So I can give it the name that I want. So it's one of the last tiles. I can move it up front again so you can see it. That's there. So I was here. Let me just close the app. So it's gone now. And now you see there's the main tile here for the sports app, which shows now the still the football information. And here is the basketball app, link, the secondary tile. When I open that one now, it opens up the app and goes immediately to the basketball part. So it's really a deep link into my app to go to that content. You have the possibility to update this information from your app, the information in the tile. For instance, with this app, this is one of the sample apps in the SDK, and this is the tile. So it says now Windows SDK. When I go here and I set send tile notification with text, it just sends some text to the tile to be shown there. So let me just press that and switch back. And now there it is, hello world, my own tile notification. So from the app, I just sent like a content to the tile, so it's shown up there. When I go back and press just clear tile, go back, it's already cleared. So that's some of the things you can do with tiles in your app. So you have the default tiles. If there's no live content or is switched off, then you provide a logo for users for that tile. And when with the different sizes, that logo is shown. And depending on the size of the tile, it can also show a name. Like in this case, you see weather or sport on the bigger tiles. And you should really think about this logo because it should really reflect your brand. If just that tile is there and there's no interactivity or the user switched off the live tile, then this is the thing that's being shown. So if it's really part of your brand, they know what it means and they feel more comfort in opening your app again because they know it's your app. Now, when you go to live tiles, you want to provide like rich and engaging content. It's not only about just showing something because you can, but make it really feel alive for the user. So in this case with the weather app, you see that in the small tile, it just says in very small information about the temperature. If it's getting bigger, there's an icon there. If you go to the really large tile, it gives an impression of the weather and gets some more information there. Again, with the sports app in this case, you see a small picture or a bigger picture with the title there. And with the big sports app, when I go here and make this one big, make it large, you see there's a big image there, and it really gives me a lot of richness to the tile on my screen. And there are different tile templates to provide these rich content options. So what makes a compelling live tile? It's very good if it's personalized and relevant for the user. So again, with the mail app, it shows my mail, and that sounds logical because it's attached to my mail account, right? But for instance, when I pinned the basketball tile, that's something that's interesting to me. So if you just show general sport tiles there while it's the deep link to the basketball sports, it doesn't make sense for me as a user. So even if I have maybe set some preferences in an app, if I have the possibility to do that, make use of that it also tailors to what kind of live tiles are shown there. So it's really custom to me as a user, and then it will draw me back faster into your app. Also make sure that there are frequent updates so that you don't get stale information, but it's still up to date and it really feels like, well, it's alive today and now. And also provide engaging and informative content. So like we see with the images, it really speaks to me because it's alive and it's beautiful and it already tells a story, so I want to get in that information. Of course, that depends on what kind of data you have in your app. Now, what's a good thing to do with live tiles is to make sure that it's a launch and resume of the app. So we saw before that I have the secondary tile and it opens up to the basketball section in the app. If the app is already open, it just resumes the app. But you have to do some things for that because the secondary app will launch your app with some extra parameters so you know what to show or where to go. Also, try to display lifetime content prominently in the hub. So again, when there's information on the tile and I open up the app and that information isn't there, I'm confused as a user and I will probably not use the app or switch off the live tile. So make sure that that content is shown there as fast as possible so the user can find it again and see more information. What you should not do is put text in an image and put that as a tile in your app. Why not? Because we talked about with windowing yesterday about the scaling, and especially with other DPIs. And if that image is not good readable in other resolution. So that's not a good idea to have the text in the image there. And also provide you can provide your tile assets for the different plateaus. So like we talked yesterday with the 100, 140, 180%, you can provide the tiles for that. So it's very crisp and clear. And don't use ads or spam in the tile. And that really violates the Windows Store conditions, so you're not allowed to do that. And that doesn't make sense to the user as well, right, to have ads in there. Another thing that's not good to do is don't use relative timestamps or time date. So in this case, it says there's a missed call 2 hours ago. But the thing is, you don't have real control over when this is updated. So then the data can get stale. I see 2 hours ago, but it might be longer. So use absolute date and time so I can make the calculation myself as a user and it's still valuable for me. Now there's a big collection of tile templates that we provide with Windows, and it's provided in the runtime. And that gives you the possibility to think about what you want to lay out on the UI. If there's an image and a text or multiple images, etc. So you have various formats that you can use. And the combination is actually, and that's how it works, your app is not running showing the lifestyle information, but actually it's done by Windows. So you provide the text and the template and maybe the links to images, and Windows makes sure that it's updated on the tiles. So that's how it's possible to have that many tiles on your screen and have them being updated all the time. Windows makes sure that it doesn't interfere with the performance of the machine, etc. So it's a very lightweight mechanism to make this possible. So this is an example of an Excel definition for all the data that's in the tile above there. So these are a few of the examples of tile templates. There are tile templates for small ones, for the larger ones, for the wide ones, just text, combination of images, or with just a picture and some text. So it's for you to choose what best fits with the kind of content you want to provide and your brand. When you have a tile that shows multiple instances, multiple types of information, you can make use of a tile notification queue, and then it shows the most recent notifications. It cycles through the last five updates, so you have only five things that you can put in the queue, and Windows makes sure that it cycles over those items. The sequence of those items is determined by Windows, so you have no control over that. So don't make it like the first line of text and then the next line of text another tile. It will not work. So make sure that you're aware of that, how that works. And you can control updates in the queue also by using expiry date or tags, so you know that you always have up-to-date information in the queue and there's up-to-date information on the live tile for the user. There are also peak tile templates, so they just peak up to show some information. For instance, in this case, there's a game here where it shows that there's a new DLC available. So that makes sense for this game. And that's just a brief information to show the tile and also show some extra information. And it draws attention to the user because, again, it's alive and it's animating. And also for peak tile, there's a collection of templates you can use to make that happen. So what you see here is the first tile and the second tile, and there's an animation there to show one or the other. Secondary tiles. Now, secondary tiles is a very useful mechanism for users to pin information to the screen that's important for them inside of the app. Now, we've seen it with the sports app, and you also see the example here with different tiles. So there's the sport tile, but also for tennis, there's a different icon. For Barcelona, there's the soccer icon. So you have different ways to provide information to the user if it's not animating. And of course, you want it to be alive, so then the content is shown there again. So this is very useful. We saw it with the different types of sport, with sports app. But you could also think when you're building, for instance, a line of business app, that it might be the customer a user is working with. So you have pin tiles to that specific customers or contracts or projects or things like that. So it's just a way for the user to get very fast back into the app and also have up-to-date information of that particular item on my start screen. When you're thinking about tile branding, using a logo, there's a place for that. Of course, you have your standard logo of your app, but there's also a way to put it in the tile, as you see, for instance, with the RSS icon there and the first tile. So make sure you think if you have to use just a small tile or a wide tile or even maybe the large tile and what the UI of that is and what the design of that is. Now, what you shouldn't do, for instance, in the top one, you see there's the alarm clock app, and also in the name it says alarm clock. So there's double information on this tile. So the name is not really necessary, or the icon should be changed. There's a way to do that in the app manifest to make to indicate if you want to have the name there or not, or on which tiles. What you also shouldn't do if you cycle through tiles, that one of the tiles is a branding tile. Don't do that. Users already know you have the possibility to use that little icon in the corner. And don't use that your own icon again in that live information, because it doesn't. It's not useful for the user. And also in the templates using images and text, don't put your branding in there as well. But really use that image maybe to identify someone or have a picture of the article, etc. You can also use badges. These are the small symbols, like we saw with the mail app, where it says how many new mails were there, the five, for instance. So there's a large collection. You can have the numbers 1 to 99, and these other icons that you can use as a badge on your tile. And this communicates the overall state of an app or of the data. And again, it draws people back into the app. And for instance, when I go back here and you see the mailbox is still there with the five items, when I open it now, it shows those new mails. When I go back to the start screen, you see the five has disappeared. So the badge is cleared because I opened up the app and saw those items. So it's not new information for me anymore. So make sure you do that as well in your app. Another thing that you shouldn't do with badges is don't have a badge there and have the information in the tile. So in this case, there is two missed video calls, and there's also a badge saying two. Again, that is too much double information there. Or use the badge, or use it in the text. And don't use a glyph if it never changes. So don't use a glyph just because you can. But really make it as a live experience for the user. Notifications is another thing you can do, and the best to describe that is with the Alarms app. So let me go to the Alarms app. Oh, Alarms, there it is. And create a new alarm, and I just put it 1 minute behind and save it. And now I lock the screen. So now I'm on the lock screen, and I just have to wait, and it already gives an icon there that the alarm is on. And when it switches to 42 now, and it takes some time, most of the time it takes a minute, maybe less. But when it's finally there and it's 42, come on, 42.
Which, incidentally, is the secret to life. or the answer.
It is, it is. And now it's a good answer, 42.
Exactly.
Now a minute is long when you wait for it, right?
Yeah, it kind of feels that way.
Yeah, there it is. So it says the alarm is there, I can snooze it or I can dismiss it. And when I dismiss it, of course. And you can also attach a sound to that. So toast notifications, there are various, it can reflect your brand, so it can have the same color there, and it will pop up on the right-hand side and the top. And this is to be used to really alert the user to something that's time sensitive. So for instance, like the alarm, so the alarm is now going off, or your next meeting is coming off, things like that. But you can also have things like maybe all the files you wanted to upload are now uploaded. So it's that kind of notifications that are important toward, to the user. And this can be delivered through notifications. And again, the user is in control. So with this notification, the user can decide what to do with it, or maybe tap on it and open the app or dismiss it. But he can even switch notifications off that he doesn't see the notifications. So it's all, this shouldn't be the main model of your app. It should be an addition to help users with notifications. Now again, also with Toast, we have templates that define the layout, and you can provide the content for that. Same as with the tiles and etc. That works the same way. And notification commands, like we saw with the alarms app, it supports for an alarm. There's only one alarm app visible for your or working in your on your lock screen, so you can only have one alarm app. And of course, the user is in control, so he or she will decide if your app is the best alarm app for his situation. Toast and tile notifications. It's very good to have, if you have a tile notification that you also reflected in, or if you have a notification that you also reflected in the tile, because the notification is transient, so it will be showed and then it will disappear in a few seconds. So if the user was to the bathroom or didn't look at his screen, he comes back, he missed that notification. But if it's also there in the lifestyle, then he gets another way to find that information and get drawn back into your app and see the information he was looking for. So when you're using Toast notifications, don't use text like click here too, because again, the user's in control. Just give him the message what's happening and let the user decide what to do. Don't notify the user for something they didn't ask for. If they didn't ask for notifications in the app to get for new data or etc., don't do it then automatically. And also don't toast for high volume of notifications. So for instance, you're uploading 100 files, and then with every file uploaded says file 1 uploaded, file 2 uploaded, file 3 uploaded. That gets annoying for the user. So it's better if that's a batch. When the complete batch is done, then you say all 100 files are uploaded now. And it's a far better experience for the user. If he wants to see in between what the status is, he will open your app anyway. Don't use it for real-time information, for non-real-time information. And don't raise Toast when the app is in the foreground. When the app is, your app is running, you have a way in your app to surface that same content, right? So those are just some don'ts for Toast notification. Now, delivering those notifications, there are a few ways to do that. You can do that local, so notification sent while the app is running, like we saw with the tile change. That's just some code in your app to make that happen. You can also have it scheduled, like with a calendar app. You want to notify people that, well, at this particular time, you want to notify them of their upcoming appointment, for instance. Or periodic notifications, just to pull information and to show it for new content. And there's also a way to push content to the machine. And you can use Windows Push Notification Service for that. And this enables delivery of tile and toast notifications over the internet. So from the back end of your server, you can use the Windows Push Notification Service to push to all of your clients, to push maybe the latest news or something that's special for your user. Also taking into account the preferences of the user. So it's really tailored to the user's interest. And in this case, the delivery doesn't require your app to be running. It's new information, like with the mail app, what you see, it's new information without the app actually running. It runs when you click the tile and open the app, right? And Windows Push Notification Service is a free service for your app to use, and it really scales to millions of users. We use it ourselves as well, and it's free for you to use as well. So how does it work, push notification? First, you request from your app a channel URI, so I have a unique identifier for your channel. Then you store that URI with your own cloud service, because your own cloud service know what the data is and when the moment is that he wants to push that information. Then the cloud service authenticates with the Windows notification service and then push that information through that channel. And that channel makes sure that it gets to all the Windows machines that app has installed and that has that notification. That information goes there and Windows shows that in the toast notification or in the tile. And then the lock screen. It's possible for your app to show up in the lock screen. And already in the standard lock screen you see things like your wireless or your battery, but also if you have new mails or upcoming appointment and things like that. There are 7 apps for quick status, so that's the little logo and a badge. In this case you see a star and 3 there. That could be the star of your app and indicating that there are 3 new items or 3 items to handle, for instance. And there's only a single app that can show detailed status information. In this case, that's the calendar app that shows lunch with Alex, etc. So again, that's with the lock screen providing information to the user that's really tailored to his interest. The splash screen, this is something that shows when your app starts. And that's the first thing that users see. And there's a few things to know with it. By default, the splash screen, you provide it only with a small image. And the rest of it is defined by a color you define in your manifest. One of the things you can do is, when it opens, it's just a static image. But if you want to have some extra work being done, loading information, for instance, you can provide an extended splash screen. And it's a very good way to mimic the start screen and then add some extra components. So it really starts getting alive and showing the user we're still doing something and now we can go to the app. For instance, show a progress ring if it takes longer. What you should do with a splash screen, use a transparent PNG because then it really can match, you can use the back color that you defined in your manifest. And it really just shows the icon, for instance, or the graphics that you use. And then it really blends in with the environment. And it also scales to various DPI plateaus. And also make sure that you provide that splash screen for that different plateaus. You have also a way to do an animation after that. There are a few apps that really make a very good use of that. There's also one that's translated to a video, so where the icon starts animating. So those are things you can do with a splash screen. Don't use a splash screen to display advertisements, because that's very annoying to the user. I know of a news app that used this to show an advertisement because he was loading news. And there was a lot of bad feedback, because so what's that ad doing there? So don't do it like that, because that's not what the user will understand. So just use progress indicators and things like that. Don't display multiple different splash screen images. Make sure it's always the same, because when the user gets back, that's where he knows your app is starting. And don't display an about page on the splash screen. I've never seen that, but Just don't. Extended splash screens, there's a very good sample in the SDK that shows how to do that. Mimic the splash screen for a smooth transition. There are some things you need to know for positioning the icon, so it's a really smooth transition instead of just placing it in the center of the screen. That you can have very strange things happening there. So again, the sample has a very good explanation for that. And also respond to resize events, because people, while it's loading and it takes some while, people can maybe resize your screen or dock another app beside your app. So make sure you take into account that kind of events. And show a progress ring if it takes more than a few seconds to load. So to recap these sessions, we've talked about tiles to make your app really appealing also when it's not active. Show live content to get people draw back into your app again. Design a lifestyle, make sure that you think of the small size and the bigger sizes and maybe even the large size, if that's useful for your app and what kind of content you want to show there. Toast notifications, we talked about that. Make it relevant to the user. Don't use it too often and make sure that's really useful for the user. We've seen that you can be part of the lock screen and show a badge there or maybe even detailed information. Again, the user is in control, so they will decide which apps will show up there. But if you support that in your app, it's a great way for users to include that information on the lock screen. And the last one, we talked about the splash screen, which is a very nice transition in your app, and especially if you have some extra work to do, make sure that you show that progress indication there, that people know that something is happening and the app is loading, and then maybe have some nice animation to showing the content. And again, if you want to do a lab on this, think about the lifestyle scenarios for your app. What kind of content can you show there? Think of secondary tiles. Is that useful for your app? What will it show? How will you update that kind of information? Think of toast notification, if that's useful for your app. And also think of scenarios for the lock screen, showing information there. So again, this is something that you can do for your app. Some resources, well, both on the Design Center and on the Dev Center, there are some guidelines there and some samples to get you started with tiles, notifications, and a lock screen, etc. So this is really helpful to implement this in your app if you don't know how to or how to design for it. Okay, there's a question. Any example of how to use Office 365 Exchange profile images in a Windows Store app? I don't know of an example for that.
No, I don't know of an example of that, but if you have programmatic access to the asset, whatever it is, then you'd be able to put it into a tile. But I don't know of an example of it.
No,
like an SDK sample or something.
Yeah, you can just have a link there that shows up in the tile. So if you have the link to that image, you can use it there.
Yeah. But
another question is, where are the various templates located, specifically Peak tile templates or Toast templates? Look it up in the Dev Center. You can find a complete list there and how you implement it. So what you do is actually indicate in your code which kind of template is being used, and you provide the data to fill that template. So that's how it works. And there's actually an enumeration of all these templates. Mm-hmm. And they're all described and showed in the documentation.
And actually, yeah, in the resources link, we have a link to both the catalogs there. So you
exactly.
can look at
yep.
them all and figure out which ones match whatever scenario you're looking to implement.
So the question, is it a legal requirement by Microsoft not to show advertisement or about us content on splash screen? Now, the advertisement part, that's part of the onboarding of your app in the store.
Yeah.
So the store team will look at that. And if you do that, they will fail your app and you will not get into the store. If you have About Us content in the splash screen, I don't think it's a certification requirement, right?
No, but the certification requirements, we'll talk about that in the next session. The certification requirements are all published, and one of the things that we'll
yep.
talk about is go through those. You know, as soon as you make the decision to become an app publisher, so you know what the requirements are.
Exactly.
As far as becoming an app publisher and publishing something to the store, and being an app that is just an app for showing advertisements, and just like a spam app is something that's against those requirements. So
yeah.
it's something that you know, you should be familiar with as soon as possible in the process of becoming an app publisher.
And again, it's all about the user. So with this live content, we want to enable user to find that content and to draw them back into your app. And all these things like not showing ads in the tiles is just because, well, that's better for the user. And otherwise, the user will just get annoyed with your app or with the live tile. Okay, that was it for now. We're going to lunch, right?
Yes.
We're having a 1 hour lunch. So, or we're having lunch, so maybe you have a late meal or a breakfast. Or
depends on where you are in the world, right?
Nothing at all. That's up to you. We'll see you back in 1 hour, and then we'll talk about the Windows Store. So, see you then.
Awesome, thanks.